It chanced upon the very day we'd got the shearing done. A buggy brought a stranger to the west of Sunday Run. He had a round and jolly face, and sleek he was and stout. He drove right up between the huts and called the super out. We chaps were smoking after tea and heard the swell inquire for one has travelled by the name of Dunn of Nevertire. Jack Dunn of Nevertire. Old Dunn of Nevertire. There wasn't one of us but knew Jack Dunn of Nevertire. Jack Dunn of Nevertire, he said. I was a mate of his, and now it's 20 years since I set eyes upon his fizz. There is no whiter man than Jack, no straighter south the line. There is no hand in all the land I'd sooner grip in mine. To help a mate in trouble, Jack would go through flood and fire. Great Scott, and don't you know the name of Dunn of Nevertire? Big Dunn of Nevertire? Long Jack from Nevertire? He stuck to me through thick and thin, Jack Dunn of Nevertire. I did a wild and foolish thing when Jack and I were mates, and I disgraced my governor's name and wished to try the States. My lamps were turned to Yankee land, for I'd some people there, and I was right when someone sent the money for my fare. I thought 'twas Dad until I took the trouble to inquire, and found the man who sent the stuff was Dunn of Nevertire. Jack Dunn of Nevertire, soft Dunn of Nevertire. He'd won some money on a race, Jack Dunn of Nevertire. Now I've returned by Liverpool a swell of Yankee brand. I reckon, guess, and calculate to wake my native land. There is no better land, I swear, in all the wide world round. I smelt the bush a month before we touched King George's Sound, and now I've come to settle down. The top of my desire is just to meet a mate of mine called Dunn of Nevertire. Was raised at Nevertire, the town of Nevertire. He humped his bluey by the name of Dunn of Nevertire. I've heard he's poor, and if he is, a proud old fool is he, but spite of that, I'll find a way to fix the old gum tree. I've bought a station in the north, the best that could be had. I want a man to pick the stock. I want a super bad. I want no bully brute to boss, no crawling, sneaking liar. My station super's name shall be Jack Dunn of Nevertire, straight Dunn of Nevertire, proud Jack from Nevertire. I guess he's known up Queensland way, Jack Dunn of Nevertire. The super said, while to his face a strange expression came, I think I've seen the man you want. I think I know the name. Had he a jolly kind of face, a free and careless way, grey eyes that seemed to smile and hair just turning grey? Clean-shaven, except a light moustache, long-limbed and tough as wire. That's him, that's Dunn, the stranger roared. Jack Dunn of Nevertire, John Dunn of Nevertire, Jack D from Nevertire. Ah, they said I'd find him here, the cursed Jack Dunn of Nevertire. I'd know his walk, the stranger cried, though sobered, I'll allow. I doubt it much, the boss replied. He don't walk that way now. Well, perhaps he don't, the stranger said, if years were hard on Jack, but if he were a mile away, I swear I'd know his back. I doubted much, the super said, and sadly puffed his briar. I guess he wears a pair of wings. Jack Dunn of Nevertire. Jack Dunn of Nevertire. Brave Dunn of Nevertire. He caught a fever nursing me. Jack Dunn of Nevertire. We took the stranger round to where a gum tree stood alone, and in the grass beside the trunk he saw a granite stone. The names of Dunn and Nevertire were plainly written there. I'm all broke up, the stranger said in sorrow and despair. I guess he has a wider run, the man that I require. He's got a river frontage now, Jack Dunn of Nevertire. Straight Dunn of Nevertire, white Jack from Nevertire. I guess St. Peter knew the name of Dunn of Nevertire.